Billy Herman first got interested in harness racing while growing up as a farm boy in Ohio. Eventually, he took a chance and moved on to the tough Roosevelt Yonkers circuit in the early 1970s. Herman admits it was quite a gamble leaving the comfort of home in the Midwest.
It's a big task for any young man to make his mind up to do that, because you're kind of hesitant to leave because you don't know what's out there. You know, I was in the Midwest. I don't know what's on the East. I don't know if I can handle it or not, you know, but you got to try. You know, you can't, at least, you know, when you're done training, if you don't make it, you say, well, at least I tried. You know, I give it a shot and I either made it or I don't make it, but you got to try it one time.
In 1973, Herman went to work as the second trainer for George Schulte. He later trained for Hanover Shoe Farm. But today, he operates a public stable on the Grand Circuit. Besides changing jobs, Herman also has had to alter his driving philosophy over the years.
I have a tendency when I was catch driving a lot, you know, you got to go with the way the horse wants you to go and the way the boys drive at the racetrack and everything else. But here, it is totally different than anything else you've ever imagined how to drive. And you have to go with the flow or you're dead. You can't drive like we used to, and you can't try to save your colt. If you put him in there to race, he better be fit to go, because you're not just going to put him in there and hope to get a nice last quarter in him and hope to win, because you're not going to. He's got to be able to go 3/4 of a mile as fast as he can go.
Among the accomplishments for Billy Herman is a driving championship at the Red Mile in Lexington, where he won the Kentucky Futurity with Noble Rogue in 1975 and with Texas 2 years later. This is John Henderson reporting.